That's James Harden and initiating contact, getting to the free throw line. And this is historical that he's shooting more free throws in the first 10 games in the history of the sport here. So how do you officiate him? If you were Doc Rivers tonight looking at the officiating on James Harden, what can you point out to say, give my guys a chance here?
Well, I think everybody needs to take a page from the Spurs book. When the Spurs guard him, they do it in such a manner to over-exaggerate showing their hands. People get into, like, trying to get into him, and, you know, they get into his airspace, and, like, he's so strong and he's so adept at drawing contact, initiating contact, selling contact, that, like, I think you – first of all, don't contest his three-point shot. When you have to lunge at him, he draws those shooting fouls. You know, that's 3 to 6 free throws a game right there. Take those out. Make him make the shot, okay? Secondly, like San Antonio does, play with your hands out wide. Never, ever, ever, never, ever reach in and try to strip. He's too strong. He's too good, and that's where he gets contact. I think if you take away those type of fouls, you can keep him to a manageable 6 to 8 free throws, but it requires great discipline, particularly if he's making shots, that you don't get frustrated. So I think it starts with discipline. It starts with taking a page out of the Spurs playbook.
I think that's great. And I think the whole keeping your hands where you have your hands so he can't use your hands against you is really a sneaky little tip there. And, you know, leave it to Popovich to figure that out.
Yeah, I mean, it's like when it's so awkward that you play with your hands out and like up, it's like it's different, you know, because usually you're telling your players, get your hands active, you know, poke at the ball, try to disrupt them. But trying to disrupt James Harden, as you said, it works to his advantage because he can use all of that to work his way to a free throw line. And you have to make him make shots. You can't take everything away from a great player, Dan, or they wouldn't be a great player. But you have to take away something. And I think the one thing you have your best chance of taking away from Harden is the free throw line if you're disciplined. And I think the second thing is that I'm surprised more teams don't do. Golden State, I had them last week against Houston when they put out that, you know, they don't have a really good team right now. But they doubled Harden on his wing isolation more than I had seen. And I think more teams should double Harden on the wing when he's isolating, particularly late in the clock, and make other guys shoot the ball and make plays off the dribble. I don't understand why you leave the best offensive player one-on-one, sometimes against 5 men. To me, that makes no sense.
You sound like a coach. Why aren't you doing that?
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV, stream for free on BR Live, or download the Dan Patrick Show app.